I'm pretty sure many of you guys have been using this idea when you calculate limits, but have you guys ever seen a proof for this? Well, let's talk about the statement first. It says, the limit as x approaching infinity of a function f of x is equal to infinity if and only if the limit as x approaching infinity of 1 over f of x is equal to 0. So, let's explain the IFF first. If and only if means that we can do two directions. The first direction is that we can say if this happens, then this will happen. And we can also go backwards. If this happens, then that happens. So this is also called a bidirectional statement. And you guessed it, if you want to prove this right here, you kind of have to do two proofs. But anyway though, let me just give you guys an example first when we go from here to here. So if we have a function, the limit as x approaching infinity, let's say natural log of x. This right here is equal to infinity. We know that, thus we can say the limit as x approaching infinity of 1 over ln x, that will be equal to 0. Nice, huh? Of course, here we go for the proof. PF first. And for the bidirectional statement, let's indicate which direction we are going first. So let me do this right here first. That means I will assume we already have the limit as x approaching infinity of some function that is equal to infinity. Then we will show that happens. But what does that mean though? Can we just put infinity to the function and say 1 over infinity and say, hey, that's equal to 0? Well, if you put this 0 down, your instructor will also put 0 down for your proof. So don't do that. You don't want that to happen. We will be, of course, using the rigorous definition of a limit. Okay, this limit. Look, the 0 here is finite, so use epsilon. We will show for all epsilon greater than 0, there exists, because x is approaching infinity, so let's use capital N. There will be an n greater than 0 such that if x is approaching infinity, if x is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, right? That means, what? How big is big? Bigger than n, such that x bigger than n will give us, so implication, the distance between our function here, which is 1 over f of x, and the limit, which is 0, the distance means that we put them in the absolute value. This distance will be less than epsilon. So it can be as close to 0 as you want. All right, continue. We assume this already. Okay, when we have for all epsilon greater than 0, let's go ahead and write down given epsilon greater than 0. To show there exists, that means we really have to write it down, choose, right? So choose capital N to be something. Choose what though? We don't know yet, don't worry. Just leave it for now. Hopefully he will come back. We can figure out that later. Now we are going to assume this and then show that. So we are going to just say, suppose x is greater than the big N, then we are going to show that. But I don't know yet, so I'll just say check absolute value 1 over f of x minus 0, and hopefully this can be shown to be less than epsilon. But now it's kind of we're stuck because we don't have an actual formula for the function to work with. I don't know if f of x is square root of 3x plus 2 or natural log of x. So what do we do? Well, let's see what are the assumptions that we can use. We also have this right here that we can use, right? So let's go ahead and just write that down. Since we know the limit as x approaching infinity of our function, that gives us infinity. So that means we know for all, well, here is infinity, so use big M. I didn't say for all because we want to be a specific one, right? For m, and of course greater than 0, you'll see. For m greater than 0, there is, and this is x approaching infinity, so we use capital N, but I wrote down n right here already, so let me just say n1, so that when x is greater than this n1, implies, that's what this arrow means, implies the distance between the, well, it doesn't make sense to say the distance between f of x infinity. Don't write absolute value of f of x minus infinity. This limit is infinity, means that the function is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, right? Implies we want f of x to be bigger than whatever the m is. Alright, so as you can see, this is just that you write down the definition from here. However, we are going to make the connections. The reason that I didn't write down anything right here is because, of course, we want to show this to be less than epsilon and somehow use this. The statement says for all m greater than 0. If it's for all m greater than 0, could I say for all m, sorry, not for all m, for n being equal to 1 over epsilon? Yes, right here you see, epsilon is greater than 0, so of course 1 over epsilon will still be greater than 0. So I'm specifically saying for n equals 1 over epsilon. This right here will be true. And we will be able to show that f of x is bigger than m, which is 1 over epsilon. Alright? Okay, have a look. We know f of x is greater than 1 over epsilon. So just have a look. I.e., can we take the reciprocal? Yes, and also remember that this thing is positive, so we can just take the reciprocal, we get 1 over f of x, and we compare that with 1, don't write down 1 over m, well you could, but like, it's this, but I'll still write 1 over m, why not? Take the reciprocal, and then we'll show that this thing, we know that will be less than, we flip the inequality. Yeah? That's exactly what we want, right? Firstly, we can take out the absolute value. Because if you want to show, because f of x is greater than 0, or greater, if f of x is going to infinity, it's positive. So that is positive, so we can just take out the absolute value. And maybe you want to specifically say somewhere, but I think that is from here, that's clear from here, so it's greater than 0. Yeah, all right, so that, and then I'll just say that's equal to epsilon. So in order for us to use this, there's one thing we have to put down. N has to be what? In order for us to use this, we must have this right here. So N has to be N1. That's it. So you just kind of have write down whatever the definitions that you have, and then just go back to fill in, so that if you read it from beginning to the end, it makes sense. For all epsilon greater than 0, choose n to be n1 from here. Suppose x is greater than n, which is the same as n1, then we'll see that this will be that, and 1 over f of x is less than 1 over m. Right, so I'll just put that down in blue. Less than 1 over m, which is the same as our epsilon. That being said, we are done. Wait, I haven't proved the other direction though. Yes, I know, so maybe I shouldn't say that. So I'll just put like half of the box. I was like, no, it doesn't make sense, that becomes rectangle, I don't like that. So I just put box without shading in. You try the other direction. You try the other direction. Seriously, go ahead and try it. Just kind of make sure that you formulate this carefully and correctly. That's it.